A Multnomah County judge Friday granted an indefinite stalking protective order to Portland Police Chief Danielle Outlaw against Oregon cop watcher Eli Ritchie. Outlaw took the witness stand and said she was alarmed and intimidated by Ritchie's behavior, describing how he followed her and filmed her on December 8 while she was walking from City Hall back to her office in the Justice Center while she was on duty. 2 days later, she said Ritchie followed her to her car in the parking garage of the downtown Safeway grocery store while she was off duty with a family member. He filmed her personal car and its license plate as she drove off, and posted the video on his YouTube site. If there's no action taken by the court, Eli Ritchie's conduct will continue, Outlaw said. There's no apparent understanding of what's reasonable. What personal space is. No delineation between private life and public life. Ritchie argued that he has the right to film the chief while she's on duty and in uniform, and said he was non-aggressive, and stayed at a reasonable distance in both December encounters. He argued that the two incidents cited don't rise to the level of alarming an individual or warrant a stalking order. Deputy City Attorney Rebecca Plaza represented the chief against Ritchie, who appeared on his own without a lawyer. Plaza entered as exhibits Ritchie's own video taken of his December 8 encounter with the chief, and surveillance video obtained from the Safeway store 2 days later. The chief testified that shortly after she took the helm of the police bureau, she received a briefing about several individuals, including Ritchie, who had visited the homes of other public officials, such as former Chief Mike Marshman and Multnomah County District Attorney Rod Underhill. Portland Police Officer Matt Miller, of the Bureau's Criminal Intelligence Division, said Ritchie's behavior in the last month, and his posting of his videos of Outlaw on his YouTube site, shows somewhat of a fixation on the chief. Outlaw said she had just bought groceries at Safeway on December 10 and was waiting with her grocery cart for the elevator down to the parking garage, when she heard someone say in what seemed like a friendly greeting, "Chief Outlaw," and turned around and was surprised to see Ritchie standing there. He said something to her like, "You usually wouldn't see me like this." The chief said she responded, "Well, we all got to eat." She described his expression as going from surprise to a flat effect. Then he got his cell phone out and questioned, "Do you know who I am?" Outlaw said she took that remark as threatening, and was concerned when Ritchie took the stairs down and started videotaping her as she was by her personal car in the garage. She noted that Ritchie is well over a foot taller and much larger in size than she, and was filming both her and her family member. Her relative was conflicted, wanting to protect Outlaw but unsure who Ritchie was, and Outlaw said she yelled at him, "Get in the car. Get in the car. I realize I am a public official," testified Outlaw, who was not in uniform Friday. "I applied for this job.